too much in the ballot box, because I don't think that any of the other major candidates will be standing for anything really good. Now, you could vote for the Libertarian Party, which is all over the place, but they're expected to get 2-3-4% of the vote,
right.
So it's not likely that that will change anything, but it could send a message to the Beltway.
We are chatting with Professor Walter Block, from who's the chair of the Economics Department at Loyola University in New Orleans, with Sheriff Richard Mack and with author Tom Mullen, basically about human freedom and the insidious ways in which the government takes it away from us. Professor, make the argument for us, please, if you would, that I know you can, that the Federal Reserve has set us on the worst of all possible courses, that a problem caused by too much borrowing and lending can never be solved by more borrowing and lending, and that we are absolutely crazy to expect the same human beings and the same mindset that caused the problem to solve it.
Well, you're such an extremist. I'm against the Fed, but they're not the worst possible thing. I think if we all got nuked, that would even be worse than the Fed. But second to that, the Fed has led us a merry chase since 1913. If you look at the roughly 100 years before and after 1913, we're almost there in terms of 100 years after. The business cycle did exist because of other interferences with the free market system before 1913, but after 1913, it's sort of like with a vengeance. And what the Fed does is misallocates resources. It entices entrepreneurs into making malinvestments due to its lowering of the interest rate artificially, because it creates extra money. And then these businessmen invest thinking that they're following the invisible hand, but it's not really the invisible hand. They invest in the wrong things, for example, cars and houses nowadays. And these misallocations, when they're found out, cause the bust part of the business cycle. I think the solution to that is what Ron Paul is now – well, he's got several hundred co-sponsors into monitoring the Fed more, but what he really wants in his heart of hearts is not to monitor them, but to get rid of them.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And if we got rid of them and went back to a gold standard and went back to constitutional economics and a constitutional economy – we might not be able to solve the present misallocations, but we certainly could at least preclude a repeat of such.
Tom Mullen, do the people understand this? I mean, Professor Block explains this in such a simple, down-to-earth economics 101 way. Do the people understand that a government strong enough to give you something, strong enough to protect you, is strong enough to take your freedoms away, and that these freedoms, once lost, rarely come back?
I think people understand it when they take the time to think about it and when they take the time to get angry about something in particular. I think what is less people are less aware of, especially with the Federal Reserve, is when you lose it by inches. And, of course, the worst thing about the Federal Reserve is that, you know, in the end, it is an instrument of theft, because when they inflate the currency, anyone who's stored up money has lost some of their wealth, and they had no recourse to say no or object, and they have legal tender laws that force them to use that currency.
One of the problems with government is the mindset of people that get in it. And if I may say so, you and I are exceptions. I used to like to say I didn't work for the government. I worked for the Constitution. The government paid me to do it, but I worked for the Constitution. But the mindset, which Professor Block points out and which Tom describes, is that the taxpayers will take any abuse you can visit on them, yeah, and that tax dollars are a bottomless pit. Let's just keep spending it.
Yeah, and I agree. And I think the frustration that Tom was talking about, that people are feeling these days, represents what I'm seeing all across the country. People are overwhelmed with the huge imbalance of power that has moved to Washington, D.C. And at USA1911.com, we're providing a solution. We believe there is a solution to this, but it's not in Washington, D.C.
Professor Block, Congressman Paul, just a little while ago, reported to us that he has 277 co-sponsors to his legislation, one of whom is his ideological opposite, Congressman Dennis Kucinich of Cleveland, Ohio. Congressman Kucinich, on my radio show, Brian and the Judge said to me, tell your friend Ron Paul that this legislation is going to pass, and eventually we will see an audit of the Fed. If Congressman Kucinich is right, And if Congressman Paul is successful, and if it passes the Senate, and if the president signs it, or if the Congress overrides a veto, a lot of ifs.
All right.
What would you expect to see there?
Well, I don't really expect to see too bloody much because all it is auditing them.
They'll audit themselves.
And what you do is you just sort of monitor them and make sure that they're not guilty of any gross fraud or something like that. But if you look at the value of the dollar now compared to 1913, I think it's worth like 3 or 4 cents. And that would continue.
Do you think?
So I see that this is just like the first step in getting rid of them.
Do you think that we could ever return to a sound commodity standard, gold being the greatest example throughout history? Or do you think that this is just sort of a fanciful thinking on the part of folks like us and the many people watching us?
Well, you know, in the Soviet Union in the 18, when did the Soviet Union go belly up? Like in 1991, I think it was?
Just about.
Well, in 1990, probably no one in the Soviet Union said, hey, you know, just wait a couple of months and we'll get rid of these guys. So who knows? Not that I'm comparing the U.S. with the Soviet Union, although I would not compare them either. They are comparable in some ways. But I don't know, where there's a will, there's a way. There's always some hope. But I really don't know what's going to happen, although I'm not really a big fan of the economic expertise of the electorate. Let me tell you a little story, if I could take about 45 seconds.
Go right ahead, Professor.
I'm from New Orleans, and in the Katrina, post-Katrina episode, before Katrina came and ruined things, well, it wasn't really Katrina, it was the Army Corps of Engineers and FEMA, but right. Before Katrina, ice was selling for, I don't know what, a dollar a bucket. And after Katrina, with a little help from the Army Corps of Engineers and FEMA, ice went up to like 20 bucks a bucket.
Yeah.
And some guy from Kentucky or Tennessee came down to New Orleans with a big truck full of ice cubes and was selling ice at 20 bucks a bucket because there was no electricity and people just didn't have it. And there was a long line of people, maybe 30 or 40 people online. And the first 4 or 5 people were served. Along came the cops and busted this gouging operation and dismantled the truck and, all the ice started to melt. And guess what happened to the other people online waiting to get their ice for the 20 bucks a bucket?
What happened?
They applauded the cops.
Oh, my.
Can you imagine that? I mean, some people say...
This is another whole Freedom Watch about how we're indoctrinated by teachers' unions.
Yes.
Into support authority, no matter how poorly or unlawfully or unconstitutionally it behaves. Professor Block, I've wanted to interview you for many years. I've been a big fan. Thanks very much, Chef, for joining us. Uh-huh. Sheriff Mack, Tom Mullen, I hope your books become bestsellers.
Thanks
for joining us
as
well.
For having me.
The best
cop
in the country. Certainly one with the most understanding of the Constitution. From Judge Napolitano at Freedom Watch, until next week, stay free. Real pleasure. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks.